Hey, what is up guys, welcome back to the channel and welcome back to Gran Turismo 7. It's that time of the month once again where we do a top 5 money method video, this time focusing on the VGTs, and whilst myself included and probably all of you guys will think the majority of them are absolutely terrible, through the bad sometimes comes the good, and there is some fairly decent VGT cars out there that are great for making money. Now the reason I've chose VGTs this time is because they are very, very easy and simplistic to tune and build, and as of late we've had a couple of great VGT cars when it comes to actually earning money in game, and I really wanted to highlight some others alongside some of these new cars as well. So as usual, I've tried to keep the list as varied as possible, meaning that it covers a span of as many events as possible and can also be used outside of the main grinding events as well. Now in terms of the rules for this one, no Group 1 VGTs allowed. The main reason for this is a lot of them are fairly decent when tuned in the Group 1 category, and I want to save the Group 1s for a different category of video, so it's purely going to be the standard VGTs only. So if there's a Group 1 VGT that you might really like to grind with and it's not on this list, that's the reason why. As for the list itself, this is going to be based purely on the cars that I've spent the most time with, meaning that overall they've been the most useful in terms of earning and grinding the credits, and will probably fall into the category of being the best for me personally. Your list may differ, and if you do have any of your own suggestions down below, then feel free to put them in. Now just another quick side note that they must be working as of update 1.43. A lot of the older VGT methods have completely gone through certain updates and such, things like the Tomahawk, the Ital Design VGT again got an absolutely massive nerf considering the change up how wet tyres would work on a dry track as well around about a year ago. So there was a lot of methods that's kind of fallen to the wayside due to updates across time. So this is going to be based purely from update 1.43, and they must be working as of that update. So intro done and dusted, let's move in to number 5, and this is one that a lot of people mentioned down in my comment section, and I do fully agree that it's a very useful car. This is the Bugatti VGT, essentially what the Chiron would become in a bit more of an extreme form. This is a serious bit of kit and a car that has earned me a ton of money along the way. I do have a full dedicated video on this car from around about September of last year, and it is still fully working as of update 1.43 and has gone on to earn me a ton of cash in game. So as you can see, the Bugatti VGT will retail at 1 million credits, 4-wheel drive, 1600 brake horsepower, however we are going to have to nerf that, 1400 kilograms and turbocharged with that insane rear wing that kind of moves around as you go under the brakes and such. So racing hard tyres for this one, as you can see some of the stuff cannot be changed, so body height cannot be touched at all. Anti-roll bar is going to be set to 6 and 6, compression 40-40, expansion 40 and 35, natural frequencies 3.25 and 440. Negative camera angle cannot be touched at all, toe angle at 0. As you can see, we've got the normal diff, cannot be edited or changed either. Normal transmission, ballast 198, but don't worry too much about that. Positioning minus 13, power restrictor 70, and fully customizable ECU set to 72. Downforce again cannot be adjusted, and neither can anything else. So again, a relatively easy build to set up. In terms of the event itself, we're going to be heading over to Sardinia Road Track, and it's going to be the WTC 800 event for this one. Super simple strategy with the Bugatti VGT, it's going to be a balancing act between fuel mix 1 and fuel mix 3. Majority of the time you are going to be running the car in fuel mix 1, it is fairly good enough on fuel to get it to the midway point and only do one single pit stop. However, you may find yourself being able to balance it at fuel mix 3 through some of those tighter sections just to ensure that it gets to the midpoint. Again, just watch your fuel usage with this one. It is rather heavy on its tyre life, but it does have a ton of performance, although we've actually nerfed it. Now you want to pit in at the end of lap 7 for your one and only pit stop. So at this point, I recommend taking a brand new set of racing hards. Again, it is rather heavy on those tyres, so just be aware of that. Although you won't really notice much in terms of a performance drop off. It'll mainly be your time, the car won't become skittish or anything like that. Once you've got the new tyres on, you also want to fill the car all the way to the top and then again just continue to balance that fuel between fuel mix 1 and fuel mix 3 for the more twisty sections. This will give you plenty of fuel to get yourself to the end, get across that line and get a very, very easy win. So here we go, we've got no fuel left, the car's just about to conk out as we go across the line. However, that is it, job done, finished, first place, nice and easy. Overall time for this one was a 24:39.237 with a fastest lap of a 1:34.149 set on lap 6. Overall, this is a great car, and to say that we've completely nerfed it into oblivion, it does maintain a ton of performance, mainly through the corners and also on those high speed straights as well. Over time, I've seen this car appear more and more in my comments section. It's one that I've already covered previously in a full video, and I fully agree that it is a fairly great and fairly useful car. Now, in terms of the payout itself, it's kind of obvious, 727,500 credits for the WTC 800 at Sardinia. Into number four now, we're going to go for something completely different this time around. So we're still going to be using Sardinia here, however we are going to be using a completely different style of car. This is the Genesis VGT, one of the latest VGT additions to the game, and one that really caught me by surprise when I originally jumped in it and realized that this thing is the perfect 800 pp machine. Features very, very good tire life and very, very good fuel consumption as well. For a car that is just ridiculous as this, I was massively taken by surprise. So in terms of the car itself, it is four-wheel drive, 869 brake horsepower, 1,060 kilograms, 1 million credits, and also features something called Super Turbo, which is really kind of out there and in your face, but it really does feel like that one. So let's head over and have a look at the tuning sheet itself, a very easy and simple one to achieve. Racing hard tyres for this one, this is the only compound you are going to need to worry about. Again, lacks the typical tuning options that we see with many other cars in the game, so you don't have to worry about suspension tuning, and you don't have to worry about the likes of differential, transmission and such like that. So in terms of the actual changes, it's going to be 85 ballast, as you can see. You just want to set that up to there, and then it's going to be positioning of minus 48. We are not restricting power on this build, which is fantastic, meaning we're getting maximum performance, and that is literally it. Super simple to achieve. Once again, you're going to head over to Sardinia Road Track, and it's going to be the WTC 800 event. However, this car is much better at Spa than the Bugatti before it, considering it does have relatively decent fuel consumption in comparison to those other vehicles. So this one, it can be used elsewhere. It's a little bit of a weird sight though, seeing the Genesis run around Spa whilst there's a bunch of Group 3s going through the rain and such. Overall though, it does work for both. Now, in terms of the vehicle itself, very, very easy to get this one running. It's a fuel mix 6 run. What you also want to be ensuring that you do is absolutely go through the gears on the exit of corners. Leave a corner in a much higher gear than you expect, and trust me, this car will treat you very, very well. It seems to be the best way to drive it. Your one and only pit stop will come at the end of lap 8, mainly due to tire wear more than the actual fuel usage itself. So in terms of its overall fuel usage, it is absolutely fantastic on its fuel, but its tire life does suffer a little bit more than the fuel itself. So we're going to head over, we're going to pit in, put a fresh new set of racing hards on, and we're also going to add the fuel in as well. Now, I would just ignore the dot at this point. You want to fill it to full, that way you can run fuel mix 1 for the rest of the stint pretty much. Again, it's just a bit of a balancing act, so get yourself underway, run it all the way to the end as much as possible on fuel mix 1, and that is going to be the race done and dusted. Again, a very, very easy method. Again, coming above the Bugatti VGT, mainly because it does provide an easier way to actually get the car working. As you can see, a time of 24:29.557, fastest lap of a 1:34.257 on lap 12, but overall a much easier build, meaning that it does jump the Bugatti to P4. Again, same payout. So from Sardinia to Tokyo for something completely different next. This is going to be the Aston Martin VGT, perhaps one of the oldest money methods in GT7 and overall one of the most reliable. Whilst it isn't absolutely the best and it isn't necessarily going to be the overall fastest way of doing it, this car has been around for such a long time and I wanted to give it a nod. So this is the Aston Martin DP100 VGT, 1 million credits as usual, starting PP is 714.66 and we're going to nerf it to 600. So to begin with, put the sports hard set of tyres on, then as you can see the suspension and then all that lot just cannot be changed once again. 198 ballast with a positioning of minus 50. Then in terms of the power restrictor, it's going to be turned down to 70. On the ECU, it's going to be fully customizable with the output at 99. As you can see, downforce cannot be adjusted. And honestly, nothing else needs changing once again. A very easy build to set up and a very reliable one for Tokyo. So head over to Asia, go to Tokyo Expressway in Japan, and then go to the WTC 600. Now once you're in there, you want to be running fuel mix 1. Again, you're going to be short shifting your way around the track. Now you should have the legs on the majority of the other cars, although the car is completely nerfed. This car does respond very, very well to very, very low revs. So as soon as you see the bar starting to fill up, I recommend just starting to shift around about a quarter of the way. Now you can use wall riding here if you do so wish. Back in the day you wasn't able to do that, but it is honestly quicker if you do want to go that way about things. On lap 4, the conditions itself will start to come into that dry territory. As you can see on lap 7, a lot of the AI will pit, meaning that you can get yourself a nice easy lead here. I do recommend having the AI themselves set on hard difficulty so you don't actually have to deal with them too much. Now this is a non-stop method. If you're shifting right, this car will go all the way to the end of the race. As you can see, we completed all 12 laps without a single pit stop. Tire life does get a bit sketchy towards the end, but it is nothing that you shouldn't be able to control. Time on this one is a bit longer, 26 minutes 51.674, a fastest lap of a 2 minute 10.704 set on lap 7. But again, the main reason this one's on here is because it's earned me so much money reliably over time that it's never really changed in terms of the build. This is a fantastic car that's earned me over 10 million credits. Next up at number 2, again, something completely different and heading back to Sardinia. This is the Mazda VGT. Now it's been around about 2 years since I even put this build on the channel. It has completely been overhauled since then due to physics changes and the fact that suspension and gearing now doesn't affect the PP rating of a car. So it's actually got better over time rather than being nerfed into oblivion, which is absolutely fantastic for such a very, very good car. So this is the LM55 VGT, 1 million credits as usual. And as you can see, everything is completely absent in terms of the stats. PP rating is 926.94. We're obviously going to be building to 800 PP. This car is fantastic for both Sardinia and especially Spa, considering its insane fuel consumption. Very much based on the 787B build as well. What you're going to want to do is have the racing hard compound of tyres on both of the wheels. And obviously, that is it. You don't need to kind of worry about changing them. If you do go to Spa though, ensure you've got the intermediate and wet. I have a separate build personally set up for Spa, but it pretty much copies everything you see here. 5 and 7 anti-roll bar, compression 27-35, expansion 35-45, frequency is 4 and 4.75, toe angle at the front is going to be 0.05 and 0.15, so it's going to be out and then in, as you can see by the diagram shown next to it. In terms of the fully customizable diff, that is going to be 5 for all of these, so just ensure they're set to the minimum value possible. Then in terms of the gearbox itself, you can't really manually adjust, so I recommend around about 320 to 330 at a maximum. You cannot adjust the manual gears either, you can only mess around with the final. So again, I recommend about 320 to 330. 169 for the ballast. For the positioning, this is going to be a little bit different. Minus 43 seems to be a bit of a glitch spot where it drops the PP rating much further down than any of the other ones. 99 on the power restrictor, fully customizable ECU set to 70, and then up to the downforce where we're going to start getting into the big downforce numbers. Now the minimum value here is 1000 on the downforce at the front, and that is what I fully recommend going for, and the maximum at the rear is 2000. So again, set them as such, and it again will drop that PP rating just due to the way that this works. Very low at the front, very high at the back, a very stable car overall. Nothing else needs changing in this build. Again, easy to set up, but the main plus point of this car is, just like the 787B from previous videos, this thing is insanely fuel efficient, and it does feature that amazing rotary sound. Definitely one of my personal favorites over time. I own about three or four of these things, and no, it is not the Group 1 that we're going to be messing around with. So you want to kind of balance between fuel mix 3 and fuel mix 6 for the first three laps of the race. After that, you can turn the car up to full. Now, if you keep it at fuel mix 6, you can complete the race without stopping. However, I just feel like that is too slow of a method and doesn't work with the nerf in terms of the power that we put on the car. So once you get to lap 4, turn the engine up to 1, and this will be good to the later stages of the race. At this point, you can just crack on and get those laps pumped in. Now I'm going to pit in at the end of lap 9. This is kind of my sweet spot when it comes to this vehicle. So I'm not going to actually change the tyres because this thing is insanely good on its tyre life. However, I am going to fill the car up to around about the diamond. Now the reason I recommend filling up to the diamond in comparison to other vehicles, it will typically take into what your average fuel consumption has been so far, and because we've been running at fuel mix 1 the majority of the time, that does seem to be the sweet spot. So we're going to go just over it, just to ensure that we've got enough fuel to the end. Then we're going to keep it at fuel mix 1 all the way to the end of the race, and that is going to be it. Job done for this car. Very, very easy to run, very, very good on its tyres, very, very fuel efficient, and honestly, one of my favourites of the VGTs in terms of any of them. A lot of people do sleep on this car, but if you essentially want a modern take on what a 787B would be today, then you cannot go wrong with the LM55 VGT. This is a fantastic car, and like I said, I own a ton of them. Also was a free gift not long ago for World Series viewers. Now, as you can see, its overall time is 24:33.063. Fastest lap was in the 1:33s with a 1:33.941, set on lap 15 when the fuel was at its least, and the tyre life though, again, holding in there all the way to the end without kind of changing them. Pretty much the entire life cycle of GT7, people have massively sworn by this car, and I can absolutely see why. So there you go, 727,500 credits for the completion. So let's head over to number one, my favorite VGT money method, and you've probably all guessed this already. There's a good reason this one is my favorite. It's because it is perhaps the easiest car to set up in the history of GT7. And that's funnily enough going to be the controversial car itself, the Bulgari VGT, that I covered around about a week ago on the channel. This car is so, so good and came out of absolutely nowhere. And for me, it takes number one spot because almost anyone can do it. It is so easy, doesn't require any suspension tuning at all, no power restrictor. It is literally just a set of tires and you are good to go. Again, a million credits for this one, a lot lower in terms of its PP rating. So 619.47, 394 brake horsepower, 1000 kilograms, and naturally aspirated. So I recommend just having the racing softs, the intermediates and the heavy wets. This car would be good for all of the 700 PP events. As you can see, the suspension cannot be edited, neither can the transmission. The only thing we're doing is adding 11 ballast, minus 44 position, and that is it. So tires, ballast, you are good to go. 700 PP and very useful for all of the WTC 700 events. So again, I fully recommend doing this one if you want perhaps the easiest setup in Gran Turismo history. So the main events I do recommend focusing on, whilst it will work for the likes of Deep Forest, Brands Hatch, Laguna Seca, Autopolis, Red Bull Ring, Dragon Trail, the main ones you want to focus on are these final two. Circuit de la Sarthe, which is the 24-hour, the typical one, 550,000. However, if you do want something different, Mount Panorama or Bathurst has a very, very decent event there. Whilst the payout is lower, it's a much quicker event to do, and you don't have to worry about the varying weather. This car will work at all of these events though. So in terms of the run itself, it's a fuel mix one run, so thankfully we don't have to begin nerfing the car. Now, the majority of the time you will get caught out by rain on lap 2 or lap 3. This is the reason I don't ever recommend nerfing the fuel mix for this car. I got a dry run here, but again, I still managed to make it work. On lap 2, start monitoring the weather. As you can see, by the time we got to lap 3, the weather was beginning to come in. Now again, it isn't actually going to hit me during this run. At this point, you're going to then pit in on lap 4, or whenever you need to pit in for the rain, and then just get it done and dusted with a new set of tyres, some more fuel, and then that is pretty much it. Good to go to the end. Now, if you want to, you can go fuel mix 6 and just potter around until the end of the race. However, for me, I just don't like the fact of nerfing cars completely, especially if they're having ballast and power restrictors put on them. And although this car only features 11 on the ballast, it would still kind of take away from the fun of driving it. Now, the majority of the time, you are going to be able to do a stop and wait here. If you can't just complete the extra lap, for me, I got to lap 7, still had a ton of time left on my dry run, and then just stopped and waited for a minute before crossing the line for P1. Overall, this is the easiest money method in Gran Turismo, absolutely. So in terms of the overall time, it is time limited, so it is a minimum of 30 minutes. I did a 30 minute 11 second as I wasn't paying attention when the timer went down, and this car can easily get in that 3 minute barrier at the WTC 700 at Le Mans. In terms of the payout, 800k for that one. So there we have it, that is the first of the Fiend, top 5 money making videos, I guess, at this point. Now, I did have two previous ones where it was pretty much the absolute best ones that I've kind of come across over the years. For this one, I just kind of wanted to highlight the VGTs. I feel like the two new ones we've had in the form of the Genesis and the Bulgari were too good not to get put in these videos. They're very easy to set up, they're very beginner friendly, and I think that was kind of the main point of going for this video, that they all cost the same at a million credits, but they're super simple to set up due to the lack of actual customization, and some of them are very, very surprisingly good. It doesn't help that the majority of them are bad, but overall, I just wanted to highlight some of the good ones amongst those bad ones. Thanks so much for watching. Let me know what you thought of the video down below, and I will see you in the next one. Take care, guys. Peace.